So for those that are new to this channel, my name is Maurice and I'm a former Wall Street investment banker at JP Morgan and then subsequently a private equity investor for about half a decade of my life, and most recently a tech executive at a Silicon Valley-based technology company. So now I come here on YouTube to try to utilize the value and the knowledge that I've acquired in the last one decade of my life to try to basically educate people around the world, right, on gaining that financial freedom, that financial success that we're all striving for. So I'm asking for you guys to do is to hit that like button below, that subscribe button below, and that notification bell. It helps me, helps with the YouTube algorithm to hopefully spread the good work that I'm trying to do here as well, so we can all rise together successfully and financially. So moving on to Ethereum as the second cryptocurrencies I like to talk about. So you can see that on the annual chart, well, not annual, just half of the year so far. Ever since in January and December time period, we were basically consolidated at about like the $600 level, and then ever since then, we rallied all the way up to the $1,300 level. And I think this was driven by both a big whale that bought in, as you see this big candle. I don't think this was mainly driven by retail investors. It's driven by I believe one of the crypto fund or an asset manager that decided to buy a big chunk. Knowing the fact that we've been consolidating on this minimal wedge here that subsequently pushed up here, and then subsequently we sold off immediately, right? And this was a very logical thing, whatever goes up really, really fast, and you see that some small retail investors start buying in, comes down really fast. So I believe some people lost money there if they sold at that moment, at the bottom right here. And then subsequently we've been pumping up because of the whole Bitcoin pump as well, that kind of have some correlations to the drag of the momentum. And subsequently we went up all the way to this new all-time high at $1,400 level. And then again, right, a big whale came in, whatever goes up really fast comes down really fast, and then we hit that bottom all the way at one point at $1,000. So that was oversold entirely, as you can see that the chart was highly oversold below the trend line that we have here. And then subsequently, because of the further adoptions and and the consolidations that we see here, we basically formed like a slight wedge here that we pushed up again, right? And this time this was a combination of both retail investors and also basically prepping ahead of the Coinbase IPO that gained a lot of traction in the media, causing this whole affectation effect to the assets price, and then subsequently rally up and then consolidated ever since. And then this was a combination of both whales and retail investors. I would say the mix is more like 50-50 or 40-60 to be in this case here. And then subsequently we sold off all the way back down to this trend line here, which is logical if you look at the line here, basically trending according to plan based on the momentum that we see here. And then we hit that bottom, which is a strong resistance level that we see. We form it basically twice now, one, two, three. About like the $1,300 level, and you can see that we retest this again in recent time, a couple weeks, a week ago to be exact, 2 weeks ago, on March 27th. So you can see that right now we are on this huge bullish run, rallying from basically the 15.6, 15.155 level all the way to this 25.50 level. And you can see that the pump is pretty significant, right? And I think right now we are extremely overbought, and it completely deviates from the charts, right? You can see that we haven't really tested or retested, and you can see that the bottoms, the resistance level here that's newly formed, deviates from the historical trends, right? So there's a gap that needs to be filled based on the quantitative perspective that we see here. And you can see that right now the RSI, we are more the oversold territory, but it's more like a not really. I would say we're not overly sold, we're not overly bought either. But because of the fact that this is such a huge gap that is forming right now, and the MACD, we are pretty crazy in terms of the volume, and the MACD line is crossing downwards, on top of the gap that we're forming, right? This is pretty worrisome to me, to be honest. I think If I was you, if you were a day trader, I think right now it would make sense to take some profit for Ethereum because I do foresee us to be coming back down and test this 1,700 or $1,800 line, and then we will go back up. You know, when we are overly sold, we go back to the RSI down here at the 38, right? But right now, I think the gap is definitely much more substantial compared to Bitcoin. Again, right? You see the gap is. Very is enormous in comparisons to Bitcoin, right? And it makes sense because it literally doubled in just the span of a week, right? We were at basically 1600 to 2600 almost, right? So now being sell off is a healthy thing because we have overly extended so much already, right? So this is my predictions. I foresee is going to be coming down all the way here. I think there's going to be a big whale that dumps this comparable to how it looks like right here. I think it looks kind of similar to this, you know, a big like whatever goes up really fast comes down really fast. And right now we have this first candle that, you know, with, you know, basically correlates to the green candle we see here. And then subsequently we will see some sort of a enormous red candle that comes down here. We potentially test this the $2,000 level, knowing the fact that this is a psychological level, and if we breach that, we will hit, yeah, definitely come back down to the $1,800 level, which, you know, I would definitely look out for. If we hit, you know, even $1,900 level, I'll start buying a lot of Ethereum, which I think, you know, in the long term wise, this is definitely going to be a safe haven, and this is going to be definitely you know, in terms of utilizations. You know, in comparisons to other cryptocurrencies, excluding Bitcoin, which I think is there's definitely value there, that this is a long-term value holder going forward. Okay, and my price predictions for that, if we are to continue trend going forward, I think, you know, it wouldn't surprise me if we hit like close to $4,000 level, knowing the fact that we have basically doubled in like a month, right? If we keep pushing and knowing the fact that Coinbase IPO already, knowing the fact that, you know, there are a lot of corporations that are still slowly, you know, adopting that you know, cryptocurrencies into their balance sheets, you know, this, you know, seeing double from here, it wouldn't really surprise me a lot. You know, we are knowing the fact that we are still in early Q2 at the moment. We still have so many months left until the end of the year. So something to look out for, and my price target for this will be like about 35, 3,950 by the end of the year, not 4,000, because again, right, the mental resistance level that I foresee that will have some type of blockage that will you know, serves as like a friction for us to get there. So next one is XRP. This is in absolutely just crazy. If you look at the chart right here, you could see that we are completely deviating from from the historical trend lines. You could see that just looking at a more of an annual basis, you could see that in earlier this year in January we were at the 18 cents level, and then subsequently we've been kind of consolidating on an uptrend. So this was something that we were, you know, I think the charts really tells you the whole story that it's been trending uptrend and also has a lot of has multiple of the lower highs on multiple occasions. You see one here, we see another one here, and then another one here. So there was three basically lower highs that serves as like a signal for the huge momentum play that happened. And you know, with this like wedge that we form here, and you know, and knowing the fact that we did have some craziness that happened early on, you know, that gave us a signal as a sold down, you know, three lower highs. This was a perfect indicator that XRP was gonna pump, right? And it did pump, and which happens here. You can see that we've been pumping enormously from the 60 cents level all the way to $2 at one point, 196 level. Right, and ever since then, you could see that people are starting to sell, right? And right now, this is a pretty worrisome chart, in my opinion. I think we are gonna see a significant sell-off coming back down all the way to the $1 level because the $1 or like flat numbers in general, people tend to be tend to have some sort of like a psychological resistance level, right? So I foresee us to be selling, in the fact that we are overly extended already in terms of the MACD. We are slowly crossing. We are still, some separations between the line, but the line is so broad that the dump is going to be dramatic based on just how the chart is coming, right? So my prediction is that we are going to be coming back down to this $1 level, or I think we might actually get down to like the 95 cents level. And I see that's going to be some sort of a scoop that bought that gets scooped up, and by that point we definitely need to look out for the the cup and handle. I think that could be a great opportunity for us to buy in on the short-term perspective as a trade. And then I see we will rally back up all the way here to this level of 150, and then we sell off again because this gap needs to be filled substantively. We don't just have things going up without like retesting it or verifying it, in both a psychological level but also in the supply and demand level as well. So we definitely will test this back here, and then we will have another bull rally coming up again, because that's just more of a natural occurrence, for charts, and especially for volatile assets like this. So that's another level to look out for. I think because of the fact that we have already seen, I think if we look at this even more further out, at one point we were at $3, so I foresee us to be, I think by the end of the year, I think that could be a stretch to for us to get like $3 or $5 at that level. I think that could be pretty crazy, knowing the fact that we tested this once already at this, like at half of this, and we didn't really go all the way, and then we are slowly selling off already. And just look at the chart again on the RSI perspective. We are so overly bought, and the chart is really deviating. So this is a pretty abnormal momentum play that we see here, that I don't first I personally don't see us going all the way to, again, right, that's $3 level again. I think there's a possibility that we will get to somewhere around like the $2 level, or like 195 level to be more realistic, to be honest. Or like somewhere maybe even $2 level, but not, definitely not $5 like some of the analysts are saying, because that's just a big stretch, right, in my opinion, in terms of the technical that we see here. So that just doesn't quite make sense to me. Unless, obviously they do something completely transformative, or unless they are doing something otherworldly, or unless there's like some black swan events again, right? Because those are the stuff that we are not able to quantify, right? Because we don't know what's going on behind some of the business fundamentals that might be shifting under our grounds. And with these business fundamentals, it can deviate how, the chart is really giving us as a perspective, right? So we need to triangulate all of those factors for us to get a confirmative assessment on the asset appreciation going forward, right? So definitely more of a risky asset, XRP, but if you're more of a risky person, I think, again, right, the $1 level isn't a good one. And long term wise, I see us hitting, close to 250, 295 at one point. So look out for it. Last one, Dogecoin. This is Dogecoin is just going crazy here, but you can see that the chart that is pretty ridiculous. I would say is extremely volatile. You can see that there was a huge dump here, this huge green candle, and ever since we oversold significantly all the way from the 50 cents, like 46.50 level. I mean, we rally all the way up from like the 12 cents all the way to the 50 cents level. That's an enormous gain. So congratulations to whoever follow Elon Musk tweets or bought because of this hype. That's an enormous gain. So really congratulations to you. I think, just this pump here made a lot of millionaires, or I don't know, even billionaires, possibly. And ever since then, we sold off here, and just based on the chart right here, and this chart is really not perfect, to be honest, because this is so volatile, and there's a lot of human emotions that baked into this one, and a lot of crazy human emotions that's in play right now. But something that I notice here in this very crazy chart that we see is that there is a resistance level that's formed pretty significantly at the 22 cents level. We basically formed this twice so far. Right now, I think we are having some sort of a rally, but we're slightly selling off right now. I foresee us to be right now, the on the RSI perspective, we are leaning more of the oversold level. So I foresee us to be maybe coming down a little bit more on this resistance level that we see at the 2640, which is a, and I think it's going to form some sort of like a new lower high again, right? Which we haven't really formed any because of this like just chaotic momentums and not even momentum, just like chaotic movements that we've been experiencing so far, that we will test this as form a new lower high and then subsequently rally back up again. And knowing the fact that, and just look at the MACD right now, we are on a more of a bullish momentum play. You could see that the MACD line has crossed the signal line, so we are on an uptrend. But I do foresee us to be like coming back down to like the 27 again, right? Like the 25 cents level, excuse me. And then come back up again, retesting this all-time high. I do foresee like Dogecoin to continue to push up, knowing the fact that this is kind of like a consolidation on a downward trend. So we're kind of forming a wedge here. So we're gonna further consolidate, maybe. And then someday Elon might tweet that, oh, I decided to put 500 million into Dogecoin for fun because he has a lot of money, then it's gonna push up the Dogecoin into possibly even a dollar. But I'm gonna give it a benefit of the doubt, 95 cents by the end of the year. That's a high possibility. So right now the resistance level again like 25 cents, and then year end 95 cents. All right. So just to recap on everything we just talked about today in a more simplistic perspective, for Ethereum 19, I think that's a good entry price. Knowing the fact that we are relatively extended right now, compared to Bitcoin, the gap definitely needs to be filled. It doesn't just go up from there without any form of like verifications or testing of the bottoms. So 1900 is a fair price point for us to get in. That's the next resistance level. If we get down to a secondary resistance level, the 1650, and if we even get down to the 15, I think that's the likelihood of this would be like 20%. Very unlikely to be, in my opinion, knowing the fact that this is slowly being more adopted going forward. And if some crazy stuff happens, right, like 1350, I think that's a steal. I don't foresee Ethereum to go back down to the three digits level. But if we ever get close to like about like 13 or 12, that's a perfect time for you to grab more shares of Ethereum. And the price year-end price target will be close to 4,000, which is going to give you about 110% upside or 2x your money if you buy now. Obviously, you could buy, as it goes down a little bit more, knowing the fact that there's been such a large gap that needs to be filled at the moment. Okay, so looking at more like the crazy cryptocurrencies, coins, like XRP and Dogecoin, these are just pretty crazy, and the deviations, in comparisons to the fundamentals of the chart is pretty kind of outliered. But with respect to what we know based on the charts here, and this is excluding like the business fundamentals and the adoption type of the analysis that you also need to do to double confirm, but these are very, obviously more of a ad hoc type of cryptocurrencies that are less mainstream in comparisons to Bitcoin and Ethereum, that are more utilization based and more corporation adopted based. So these are, you need to like really look at these numbers with a huge grain of salt, but these can demand high return for you if you are catching on the right momentum trains. Okay, so for Ripple, for XRP, fair prices are going to be $1.05 right now, knowing the fact that we're completely stretched out all the way to like the $2 level. And right now we are already seeing some sell-off, and I think we will see some sell-off, knowing the fact that whatever rockets goes up really fast comes down really fast at the same time. And the next resistance level, based on the mid level of the resistance of this bullish pump, will be 105. So look out for that price point somewhere around the $1 level, or 99 cents if you get in. That I think that's a pretty attractive price point. If we get down to 93, which is basically the quantitative analysis that shows that resistance level at 93 cents, if we get down to this 60 cents again, like a couple months ago, and I can't believe only a couple months ago we were like trading at like 55 cents. That's a attractive level, but that's if we ever get down to these levels again, I think that's a pretty worrisome thing to do because I don't think I think these type of things happens maybe once as a verification, but if that happens second as a second time, that's a little bit more worrisome in my opinion, as a retest, right? You don't retest things twice, because that gives you just it kind of hinders the confidence in investors about this as a as an asset that provides value for a long-term perspective. It just doesn't fluctuate that way, right? Not in this magnitude at least. But long-term wise, if everything goes well in the momentum perspective, in terms of like we're still on the uptrend in terms of the cryptocurrencies macro adoptions going forward, I do foresee this to hit somewhere around like the $3 level, 295, not all-time high, but close to all-time high, about like the 181% and 2 point, well, close to 3 times your money from here, if you buy in now, buy in at the 105 level. Lastly, Dogecoin, I think right now, if you really want to buy 27 cents, I think that's the next resistance level. That's fair. If you're a gambler or you're more risky, more adventurous, I think that's a better word. The next resistance level, knowing the fact that the chart is kind of all over the place, 25 cents would be fair if you are, again, right, more adventurous, right? And if we ever get down to this like bottom resistance level at the 18 cents and 13 cents, I think those are fair price, for us to get there. Contingent on looking at the RSI and the MACD, making sure that we are trading on the right levels, right? And if all of them connect and you triangulate all of that, all your research, you could make some massive gains, knowing the fact that a lot of people made like 4,000% return or something like that, something otherworldly. And my year-end price target, again, right, contingent on the macro trend that we are trending in the right directions going forward, I think somewhere around like the dollar level, 95 cents level, I think that's fair. And that could give you a potential 250% upside or close to 4 times your money. Insane by the end of year if you buy in the 27 level. All right, so that's it for the day for the quantitative analysis on my cryptocurrencies outlook in the near future. Really appreciate you guys dropping by again. Please again hit the like buttons, the subscribe button, and that bell of notification as well. I really appreciate it. I really enjoy doing this every single day. I feel like it's so fun to be connecting with you guys and also being able to provide value to you guys. That's something that I really look forward to doing every single day. So stay tuned and please look out for the next video.